My most distinguished guests, I'm sure you have the stage. There is...
The sun's about to set, and the moon soon to rise. Our time is almost up, but evil survives. The famed attendants all took on the dragon, but they fell one by one. I made a vow when all of this began. But now I fear my vow has become a farce.
As her most loyal servant, I should share her worries. I am a nobody, but thanks to her, I was given a place. Nevertheless, I admire the princess's diligence and kindness. Please, don't dwell in sadness. We can reflect on the trio's mistakes.
Die again, then lay a hand on me.
Your counsel is valid. Let me recall their words and deeds.
An inflated ego, yet falling at the first hurdle. The princess remembered what she'd seen.
I fancied myself a fighter, but my enemy saw right through me. I overestimated my ability. I couldn't win against a strong enemy, but I also clung hard to my conceit. I lacked respect because I feared others wouldn't respect me.
A dream that was massive in size, yet hollow inside. Lots of guts, but no ability.
A supposedly foolproof plan, yet with no one to see it through. The princess remembered again.
Myself, I ran away and let others take my place. All my plans evaporated when I saw the dragon in front of me. I did survive everything, but every time I did so by abandoning those standing next to me.
He was a tactician with neither morals nor strategy. It's natural to be cautious, but one who abandons their comrades is no hero.
Avoiding the present and only speaking endlessly of past glories, the princess remembered one last time.
Huh!
My past has proved my deeds. My laurels should now be able to speak for me. To give my life now would be foolish. It's elementary to balance risk and benefits.
His past has faded. All he has now is his former glory. The spirit has decayed. He has long forgotten the taste of his dream. Ah, if they all failed to defeat the dragon, then I... With only my dream and my rapier, how can I possibly defeat the dragon?
Though I am but a lowly bystander in the palace, I know you to be humble and grounded. You are never selfish or merciless. All know you for your eagerness and diligence, your dreams that are no less than gold. Your Highness, please don't underestimate yourself. Believe in your golden ideals, and that you will slay that dream-devouring dragon for good.
If it's useful, I'll take it.
It is almost night. The dragon has changed its name to the Starving One.
Snack, but dinner still eludes me. Snacks are distractions. In the end, they have no true substance. What's more, some of these just made me feel sick. I'm afraid only a true golden dream can sufficiently quench my cravings.
The loyal servant approached quietly to observe the dragon. For the princess, he will do any and everything.
For my promise to the king, but also to make her happy, even if it seems impossible. Huh? The dragon looks strange. Why is it covering its chest? Let's hear what it's mumbling.
I shouldn't have underestimated the humans, or been so gluttonous. Now that my stomach is churning, I have no strength left to face off against the king.
Overjoyed, the loyal servant rushed back to share the news.
My heart is full of courage. I will wield my rapier with pride.
Look! There's a spot above its heart that isn't covered by scales! Take it down while it's still weak.
Evil dragon, I challenge thee to protect my kingdom!
Filthy human!
With a fearless thrust, the princess fulfilled her pledge.
The world opens itself before those who do not forget their dreams and nobility. Thank you as well, my loyal servant. You deserve a fitting reward. In light of our recent trials, I will name you...
The Shatterer of Despair, Flugel der Dunkelheit, Servant of the Prinzessin der Varatylon. Finally, The princess personally defeated the dragon, and peace returned to the kingdom. All praise, all praise.
If it's useful, I'll take it.
Our thanks. I really appreciated you. Yes. Anyway, back to bit, please. Is everyone ready? 3, 2, 1, yes!
Whoa! Tone down the excitement, buddy. Are you sure?
Thank you.